to our 10:45 traditional service for today, Sunday, the 14th of March, as we continue our Lent journey towards the cross. And it is just great to have you here, wherever you are connecting from, whether it's in a nursing home, another church, or if you're a regular attendee of here, the Turramurra Uniting Church. My name is Phil Swain, I'm the minister here, and it is just great that you are gathering with us this morning on this pre-recorded online service. We're going to start our time of worship by singing our introit. And our Lent introit is the beautiful song 390. We're going to sing just one verse of it. Alleluia, alleluia, give thanks to the risen Lord. Continue in worship and prayer. Let's pray. Creator God, you offer us new life through your Son. As we continue to journey through Lent, grow in us an awareness of the gifts that you have placed in our lives and a greater appreciation of your care for us. Help us to praise you this morning. Help us to see the beauty and the mystery of this season. Let us lean into instead of run from the pain of Easter. As we worship you, may we see how your saving grace and your loving touch can fill us with joyful praise. Lord God, we thank you for your love that you've poured out on us. Help us to follow more closely in the path that you have set for us, the path of your Son, in whose name we pray. Amen. For our hymn of praise for this morning, I was trying to think of some hymns that we haven't sung for a while. And one of our favourite hymns we haven't sung for a while, which is How Great Thou Art. So I'm going to use this as a hymn of praise this morning as we lift up our hearts, lift up our voices in praise and thanksgiving. Let's sing together the great hymn, How Great Thou Art.
Thank you.
enjoy singing that hymn? What a great way to start the service. Just before we come to our responsive psalm, we just take a moment to, in our hearts and our minds, remember the people that we are worshipping with this morning. And we've been doing that by sharing a virtual sign of the peace with each other. And so I offer you the peace of the Lord be with you and also with you. Let's just take a moment to reflect upon those people whom we would normally be worshiping with and give thanks to God for our church family. Our responsive psalm for today is actually connected in with our Bible reading. We've been looking at Jesus' words from the cross, and today the words that Jesus speaks from the cross are actually a quote from a psalm, and so I've used that psalm as our responsive reading. We're going to read together the first five verses of Psalm 22. I'll read the first part of the verse. I encourage you to read the second part. Let's say this together. My God, my God, why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far from saving me, so far from my cries of anguish? My God, I cry out day by day, but you do not answer, by night, but I find no rest. Yet you are enthroned as the Holy One. You are the one Israel praises. In you our ancestors put their trust. They trusted and you delivered them. To you they cried out and were saved. In you they trusted and were not put to shame. Did you recognize that first verse? They're the words that Jesus said from the cross that we're going to be looking at today. And as we continue to prepare ourselves for Easter, our Easter hymn for today is the beautiful hymn 339, O Sacred Head Once Wounded. Let's sing this hymn together as we prepare for our Bible reading for today.
Oh, sacred head, now wounded, with grief and shame weighed down, now scornfully surrounded with thorns, thy but thine the deadly pain.
Our Bible reading continues the Easter narrative, but this time we're moving to the Gospel of Matthew and hearing Matthew's rendition of what happened, what Jesus said on the cross. And so we're going to be reading from Matthew chapter 27, and I hand over to the reader who's going to read that for us.
I'm reading from Matthew chapter 27, verses 45 to 56. The death of Jesus. From the sixth hour until the ninth hour, darkness came over all the land. About the ninth hour, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of those standing there heard this, they said, "He's calling Elijah." Immediately, one of them ran and got a sponge. He filled it with wine vinegar, put it on a stick, and offered it to Jesus to drink. The rest said, "Now leave him alone. Let's see if Elijah comes to save him." And when Jesus had cried out again in a loud voice, he gave up his spirit. At that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. The earth shook and the rocks split. The tombs broke open and the bodies of many holy people who had died were raised to life. They came out of the tombs, and after Jesus' resurrection, they went into the holy city and appeared to many people. When the centurion and those with him who were guarding Jesus saw the earthquake and all that had happened, they were terrified and exclaimed, "Surely he was the Son of God." Many women were there watching from a distance. They had followed Jesus from Galilee to care for his needs. Among them were Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James and Joseph, and the mother of Zebedee's sons. This is the word of the Lord.
So as I've been saying, we've been looking at these seven sayings of Jesus from the cross. So far, we've looked at Father, forgive them. The cross solves the problem of sin. We've looked at today, you will be with me in paradise, when Jesus said that to the thief on the cross next to him, as a way of highlighting the choice that we have of whether to accept this grace and forgiveness or not. And last week we looked at the saying that Jesus said to his mother and to John the disciple, "Here is your mother, here is your son." And in that reading we explore this idea how Jesus was saying that relationships are a priority and that the cross helps us to be in relationship with God. Today we'll look at the fourth saying from the cross, one which is a little darker, a little harder to hear than the others. My God, why have you forsaken me? Why have you abandoned me? As I said, this saying is a little darker than the other, the first three. It's full of anguish, it's full of hurt, it's full of pain. But let's just try and put this statement in by Jesus from the cross into context. As we mentioned last week, Jesus had been on the cross for quite some time at this point. And we assume, you know, it's probably, you know, 3 hours by now. And we're starting to come to the point where Jesus is getting closer to his point of death. And I guess when Jesus was first crucified, there would have been a large crowd of people around. They would have been rowdy and loud. They would have cheered or mocked or shouted, maybe even placed wagers of how long they were going to last before dying. But as the hours went on, the crowd would have disappeared. Some would have drifted away, some would have remained. But as I mentioned last week, it was about this time that Jesus' friends were able to draw close to the cross, feel more comfortable coming close as the crowds drifted off. Not too close, because there were still soldiers at the foot of the cross who were on guard. But it was around 3 hours after Jesus was crucified that something changed. The Bible tells us that darkness fell on the land. It happened so fast that nobody was really expecting that. One moment the sun was out, the next moment it had disappeared. It wasn't an eclipse. It was like this dark cloud descended and darkness came upon where Jesus was crucified, came upon the land like a shroud. And I'm sure that the people who were still at the foot of the cross might have gone silent in a bit of awe or fear. Nobody would have moved, nobody would have spoken, because something was going on. And this darkness wasn't just for a moment. The Bible tells us that it lasted until Jesus died, which we're assuming is probably another 3 hours away. So the end was near. Jesus is approaching the point of death. And that's when he cries out these words that we're looking at today. Only 4 words, but they came with so much hurt and so much passion. Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani? Or as we say in English, my God, why have you abandoned me? I can't even begin to imagine how Jesus would be feeling at this point. But Jesus is giving us a hint that he felt alone, that he felt forsaken, that he felt abandoned. Have you ever had times in your life where you felt that way? Where darkness has descended upon you, that you're going through a difficult time and it just feels like that you're all alone, that people have abandoned you? I remember a number of years ago, in my last church, I had a very dark period in my ministry. I was struggling. I'd made some mistakes that had hurt people. I was working as hard as I could to try and correct things, but things didn't seem to make any difference. I was seeing no results to my labor. It really was like a darkness had descended upon me. And I was questioning a lot of things. I was even asking the question, was I really cut out to be a minister? Was I the right person for this church? Was I hindering the kingdom of God or helping it? I knew in my head I was probably overreacting, but it didn't take away the darkness and that sense of aloneness. You see, the worst part of this whole experience was that I was struggling to feel God near to me. I tried, I prayed, I threw myself into more work. I tried reaching out to God, but for whatever reason, this darkness was fooling me, deceiving me, tricking me into thinking that God was not nearby. And I don't know, that I felt like crying out, my God, why have you abandoned me? Reminded me of another story that I once read. Of a woman who was very angry with God. Like me, she was going through a dark patch in her life. Her marriage had broken down after, you know, the love that they had shared seemed to drift into more anger and abuse. Her kids had made bad choices in life and now were suffering because of those choices, suffering the consequences. And now her doctor had told her that she had cancer and that they would need to do some more tests. And it just felt like her whole life was just one blow after the other. And she was walking down the road after visiting the doctor, and she was feeling that darkness, that heaviness descend upon her. And she was feeling very down, and then it started to rain. And it was almost like, why? Why me? Why are all these bad things happening to me? Why, God? What have I done to deserve this? To get out of the rain, she noticed there was a little church up ahead with the doors open. And to get out of the rain, she ducked inside the church and found herself in an empty side chapel of a Catholic church. And the side chapel just had a few seats, but up the front of the chapel there was a large cross with a crucifix, so a cross with Jesus on it, a marble crucifix. And I don't know, it was something about seeing Jesus on the cross that just made her snap. And she walked up to this cross and she let all that anger and that built up hurt within her flow out in the words that she yelled at Jesus on the cross. And she said, "Why me?" she said, speaking to the cross. "Why me?" And she let her anger come out. Why are these stuff happening? Why did God allow this? And the more she spoke at the cross, the more she pointed her finger and was blaming God. You see, she had felt the presence of God when she was younger. But now, when she needed God the most, it was like God had gone away. And so as she pointed her accusing finger at this marble crucifix, she said, "You have no idea what it's like. You have no idea what it means to be all alone, to be abandoned, to be left in this dark place." And as she stood there saying those words, the verse that we heard today from our Bible reading came back to her. My God, why have you abandoned me?" And tears began to flow when it all became clear that actually Jesus did understand. Jesus did get it, because he also felt that sense of aloneness and abandonedness on the cross. She suddenly realized that this Jesus could understand what she was going through. And it was a turning point in her life. Not that things became better, things were still tough, but she continued with the knowledge that Jesus understood. She knew that Jesus would never leave her because he understood that pain of what it was to be left alone on the cross. Looking back at my dark point in my ministry those years ago, I know that Jesus never left me. Even though I was struggling to feel it at the time, I know that Jesus was there. See, Jesus said those words on the cross, my God, why have you abandoned me?" He said those words with the knowledge that because of the cross, I would never have to say those words. Because of the cross, I would never have to have that same experience that Jesus went through of feeling alone and abandoned. It is my prayer today that we can all embrace that truth in our lives. These words that Jesus spoke from the cross, my God, why have you abandoned me, are so significant, are so meaningful, not because they're true for us, but rather because of what Jesus did on the cross, they will never be true for us. Hear the good news. Because of the cross, we are now never alone. We are never forsaken. Because God will never, ever abandon us. God is always with us. Amen. Let's celebrate that good news by singing the wonderful hymn 588, "In Heavenly Love Abiding." before we come to our prayers for others, our prayers of intercession, we just acknowledge our offerings. And the way we do that in our church is that even though we're not in the building at the moment, we celebrate the different ways that people have been giving, and we give thanks to God by singing together the doxology. So let's do that now. And just before our prayers, just a few very quick announcements. A reminder that for the weeks leading up to Easter, we're just online only for this traditional service. But from Easter Sunday onwards, we will be back in person every single week here at our traditional service at 10:45. So that is great news. We will still be doing our pre-recorded service. We're just trying to work out the best way of making that happen. That still will continue, but remember it's pre-recorded for the next three Sundays, but then on next two Sundays, but then on Easter Sunday, we are back in person every week. Speaking of Easter, on Palm Sunday, our church is having a picnic down in South Turramurra in the village greens, right next to South Turramurra Uniting Church. If you would like to come to that picnic, it's at 9:30 in the morning. Very short time of simple worship, followed by bring your own morning tea together. We'd love to see you there. And for our Easter services, we've got three different Easter services on Maundy Thursday at 7 o'clock. We've got the Maundy Thursday service. It's a time of sharing together in communion, and then the service of the tenebrae candles, the service of the darkness. So that's on Maundy Thursday. On Good Friday, our service is at 10 a.m. Where we will be joining together with all the other congregations here for that service. And on Easter Sunday, our service will be here. It will be at 11 o'clock, not 10:45. That's because we have a very large Easter egg hunt before that, and there will be kids and Easter eggs everywhere. And so we're just giving ourselves an extra 15 minutes to clean up after that. But come along and check out the Easter egg hunt if you want. But at 11 o'clock, we will be sharing together in our Easter service here in the chapel. We'll also be sharing on communion that day as well, because it's the first Sunday of the month. I think that's all the announcements I have for the moment, so let's move into a time of prayer. Let's pray. Jesus, in his time of need, cried out to God for help. So we are invited also to cry out to God for help in our prayers for others. So let's do that now. God of love, hear the cries of those who yearn for love. Be with those from fractured families, from broken homes, those people who are feeling neglected, unwanted or alone. God of love, hear our prayer. God of justice, hear the cry of those who yearn for justice, persecuted and oppressed, exploited or ill-treated and broken. God of justice, hear our prayer. God of peace, hear the cry of those who yearn for peace in battle zones or broken states. Be with those people who are feeling frightened or fearful or anxious. God of peace, hear our prayer. God of healing, hear the cry of those who yearn for healing. Those people that we know who are struggling, whether it's with physical or mental or spiritual health. We remember those people who are hurting or weakened or depressed. God of healing, hear our prayer. God of mercy, hear the cry of those who yearn for mercy, convicted in need of your grace, contrite, humbled, bowed down. God of mercy, hear our prayer. God of love and justice and peace and healing and mercy, we cry out to you, lifting up the names and the situations that are weighing heavily on our hearts and minds. We ask for your help as we name these people to you in silence. As we pray, we echo the words of the psalmist. We love the Lord because you have heard our voices. The Lord has heard our cry for mercy. So may we all know the peace of God, the love of God, the justice of God, the healing and mercy of God this day and all days. Amen. We come to our last song as we've been just praying and asking for God's help. This last hymn reflects what we've been doing. The beautiful hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus, hymn number 590. And I have chosen for us, I've used this before, but a beautiful version done by an African children's choir. Just the passion and energy that they sing this song with is quite infectious. So let's join together in this beautiful hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Well, thanks for joining with us today. I hope it's been a helpful reflection on the words of Jesus and how they can relate to us. May we now go from this place with that knowledge that because of the cross, we will never be alone, that we will never be forsaken, that God promises to be with us, to help us, and to sustain us always. Let us go with that knowledge, and may the blessing of God in all God's fullness be with you and your loved ones today and forevermore. Amen. Let's sing together our benediction song, Now Unto Him.
Now unto Him who is able to keep you from falling, and present you faultless before the presence of His glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen.
Once again, thanks for joining with us. We've got a couple more services on this journey towards Easter, looking at the sayings of Jesus on the cross. I look forward to sharing the next lot with you next week. If you have any questions, want to make some comments, or just want to say hello, here are my contact details on the screen. You can send me an email or give me a call. But for now, thanks for joining with us, and we'll see you next week. Bye for now.